This is, yes, this is Match Game 74, and it's production number 0286, and it's take one.
Get ready to match the star. Scoey Mitchell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Wright. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. Yay! And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
I've got something I want to say.
Yes?
I got the horse right here. How's everybody over here?
Sensational.
Nice to have you back, Scoey.
Hey, it's nice to be back.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I wasn't working.
Listen, your shirt is unbuttoned, and it's arousing my libido. And I don't even know what that is, or if I've got one.
As long as they keep it a tight shot.
Okay. How are you?
I'm fine, Doc.
Good. Congratulations. I'll tell you about that later. Yes, sir?
I have a very important announcement.
What is your announcement, Richard?
You know, I've just been to the islands, Hawaii.
Yes.
My younger son, Gary, is engaged to be married.
Really?
He's 12 years old. Sure, he's standing right over there. I want to tip this so you can see the lovely lady. You see her? Is it glaring? I don't want it to
glare. No,
well, I can.
Yeah,
there she is.
Head.
Well,
yeah.
This is not the closest shot we've had, folks, but...
Well, it's all right.
Equipment from Accra. I've got snapshots at home, you can see. There she is. Yeah. Here. Gary's, her name is Paulette.
Her name is Paulette?
Her name is Paulette, and Gary is getting ready to get married. He's mowed the lawn three times this week. We had a great time there.
Isn't he a little young for that?
Well, he doesn't think so, neither do I.
All right. Okay. All right. Congratulations and best
I'll be
wishes.
The assistant gardener.
Let's say hello to our two players, Darcy Bell and Roslyn Hill.
Oh, yeah.
Darcy is our current champ with $6,200. Are you happy about that, Darcy?
Very.
I guess she is. Now, we're in the middle of round one. She's being challenged by Roslyn Hills, which is this lady's name. It's not a place in Westchester County. And it's nice to have you back here again with us, Roslyn. You all ready?
Thank you. Yes.
Okay. We'll continue this game right after this message.
Wonderful.
Hello there. Okay, I'll push this button and reveal our B question, which is for Darcy. You had your first round question match two celebrities. Now let's see how Darcy does with hers. At the gas station, dumb Dora stuck the air hose in her mouth, and before she knew what happened, her blank was inflated at 10 times its normal size.
Honey,
I had to try that.
Fanny, stop acting so tacky.
Where what did was she that stick question?
At the gas station, dumb Dora stuck the air hose in her mouth.
In her mouth.
Before she knew what happened, her blank was inflated at 10 times its normal size.
Gracious.
We all right.
Are you?
Okay.
Good.
Are you all right?
Everybody writes because this is a first round question for Darcy Bell there. It's her first go-in.
Do you know that Charles Nelson Reilly could take the excitement out of an earthquake just by showing up? You've got to wake up now, Charles.
Are you with it, Charles?
Yes, but my light was flashing, don't right?
Uh-oh. Well, Charles, it's been a long weekend. No? Today is Tuesday, though, isn't it? It hasn't been a long weekend. What is today,
Wednesday,
Ira?
October.
Today's Tuesday, right. Okay. All right, here we go, Darcy Bell. At the gas station, dumb Dora stuck the air hose in her mouth, and before she knew what happened, her blank was inflated at 10 times its normal size. We need an answer from you, which you think will match the dingbats over there. What do you say?
Her bust.
Her what?
Her bust.
Her bust. Her bust. Her bust.
I'm sorry, what were you doing down there?
I thought you dropped an earring.
Yeah.
A cat.
She said her bust, Scoey. That's the answer she's looking for. What do you say?
You remember the last time I was on the show, I played so well that they almost didn't book me back.
That's right. Frankly, I was kind of surprised to see her. I don't do the bookings, so but here you are, Scoey.
I try to cover myself as well as possible with little blanket answers like, I said her buns.
No.
Oh, I see. All right. Some of them know what buns are. Oh. All right, what do you say there? No match, Scoey.
Geographically, this is
a match. No. It does not match her answer.
Now, if you think it's a match, you don't know if you're coming or going.
All right, Brett, my dear.
It's going to be a long week, isn't it?
It's going to be a long week there. All right, Brett.
Well, it wasn't easy because this girl had already borrowed Fanny's D cup. Oh. Bosom.
Bosom, she said. So there's one match. Darcy?
Charles? I mean, the last time Scoey was on, he said buns to everything, too, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
I think so, yeah. Blanking
I said in. Busty. Boo.
Okay, so that's...
Now, my dear?
Well, I wanted her to win, so I agreed, and I said breast.
Okay. Well...
Just one.
Had three different names for it so far. What do you say?
Here it comes.
Well, good things always come in pairs.
Yeah.
Bazoo.
All right. Now, what do you say?
You tell him, Fanny.
Bust, okay. What is that? Is that the man in the moon?
The man in the moon is a lady.
Okay, all right. That's
Doo-dah.
It, folks.
Doo-dah.
Doo-dah. All right, Darcy Bell, you have 5. Rosalind Hills has 2. We go to round 2. You must score 3 to stay in the game. What do you say, Rosalind?
A, please.
A. She has a choice here. Elaine will not play. Charles will not play. The rest do.
Oh.
When Tarzan went to the first annual jungle wife swapping party, he swapped Jane for a blank.
Honey, my hearing aid's gone completely off.
I'll give it to you again. When Tarzan went to the first annual jungle wife swapping party, he swapped Jane for a blank. See, he and Jane were married.
Who says?
Well, I say. Well, now they were living in the same tent for a long time.
Just put down buns, honey. You'll be fine.
Could I hear the question
yes,
again?
Yes, of course. When Tarzan went to the first annual jungle wife swapping party, he swapped his wife, Jane, for a blank. I recognize that they were married.
You
and
S.
They were not married?
No.
They were just good friends.
No.
They never got married.
They never got married?
I read the book.
Okay, everybody's ready. Rosalind Hills. When Tarzan went to the first annual jungle wife swapping party, he swapped Jane for a...
For an ape.
For an ape?
Yes.
Okay. All right. You like that? Think that'll work? Okay, Scoey. Rosalind says ape.
Come on, Scoey, you can do it, sweetheart.
He said buttons.
This is another geographical answer.
What is? Who else was at the party?
I'm surprised Rosalind didn't say gorilla.
Gorilla.
Gorilla. Same thing. Yeah. That's a match.
Okay. There you go. Brett?
Scoey's in shock. He got it right. I said chimp. Is that a match?
That's an ape. Yeah. Richard, we swing over to you, sir.
Yes.
The answer she's looking for is ape.
He already had Cheetah.
Oh.
Who was an ape, right?
Oh, I see.
And he got nowhere with him. But I know what he really desperately needed was a refrigerator.
A refrigerator. You got to match Fanny to stay in the game. Let's see if it happens.
First of all, I'd like to tell you about my friend Tarzan.
Yes.
He jumped from the vine, he jumped into the house, and he ran, and he says, Jane, give me a double martini fast. he drank it, and he said, give me another. And she said, why are you drinking so much? He said, you don't understand. It's just a jungle out there.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have a tie at this moment.
Oh, I love tiebreakers.
And we've got, well, we don't want to go to tiebreaker because she has her question, and she will need one match to win the game when we come back after this tie. Here we go. The second half of our second and final round, question for Darcy Bell. You matched everyone except Scoey.
Ho, ho, ho.
Scoey, this is for you only. Now, the score is tied at this moment. If she scores, if she matches your answer, why, she will win the game. All right, here we go. Sam went to sleep and dreamed he was a master of the art of self-defense. When he woke up, he discovered he was kung-fuing his blank.
You'll never match this.
How close, Scoey? Darcy's thinking about that. Did you hear all of that, Darcy? Okay. Sam went to sleep and dreamed he was a master of the art of self-defense. When he woke up, he discovered he was kung-fuing his blank.
I wish somebody would kung-fu me once in a while.
Did you finish?
Yes.
Did you put it? Oh, it's in there. Oh, I'm sorry. You're light lit, and I didn't even know it was lit there. All right, Darcy.
That's because you're lit.
He was a master of the art of self-defense. When he woke up, he discovered he was kung-fuing his...
wife?
His wife.
Husband.
All right. She said wife, Scoey. If you say wife, she wins the game. What do you say?
Oh, I looked at her.
Yeah.
And I said, she's such a... pretty pure-looking young lady, and I just didn't expect anything physical like that. I said pillow.
Kung Fu is pillow.
Oh,
did you think of pillow?
Second, yeah.
Pillow was the first answer that came to my mind. All right, we've got a tie here. It ends that way, this game, so we wipe the slate clean on this game and push the button and reveal one tie-breaking question for each of our contestants here and ask Rosalind to make her selection.
A.
The one who scored the most will be the winner. One question for each. Everybody plays. The agent said to King Kong, he said, Kong, baby, I got a great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a blank. That's what his agent said.
What?
His agent said to him, King Kong, he says, Kong, baby, listen to me. I got a great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a blank. This is his agent talking to King Kong.
I know there's a joke there, but I can't find it.
Well, think about it.
Oh, I know. I know what it
is.
Now, don't talk about it because, you know...
endorsing a blank.
Could I hear it again?
Yes. The agent said to King Kong, Kong, baby, I got a great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a blank. Would you like to give us the Irving Lazar reading?
Agent said to King Kong.
I think that's a hard question.
Kong, baby, I've got this great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a...
Stop imitating me.
Well, that's his Irving Lazar imitation.
No, it was Charlie.
It was Charlie. Right.
Do not tell a lie.
Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Okay, Rosalind Hills. The agent said to King Kong, Kong, baby, I got a great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a...
the only thing I can think of is a deodorant.
A deodorant? Oh, really? Well, okay.
Why do you think she does?
Some of you like that and some of you don't like it. We'll find out how it works over here with our celebrity. She said deodorant. Scoey, what do you say?
Well, first thing came to my mind is the way apes are built. You know, they're very, you know. And I said bra.
A bra, okay. All right.
King Kong. That's enough
for all. All right. What do you say?
I wish I'd said deodorant.
Is that a good one?
Yeah, I think that's a terrific answer. Can I change?
No.
Oh.
Show us
I said a Fay Ray doll.
A Fay Ray doll.
Faye Ray doll.
Yeah. A Faye Ray doll.
Selling Faye Ray
doll. He was in love with Faye Ray, and people are so hateful they wouldn't let them get married.
Charles?
He was Catholic. What did you say?
May we see yours?
I'm not. No one that's kung fu'd you? Is that what you said before? Yeah. Banana.
Come on, baby, I got a great job for you. You're going to do a commercial endorsing a banana, is what Charles said.
Those answers.
Rosalind said deodorant. What do you say?
Very good answers. I mean, King Kong was really a smelly ape, you know? That's why he hung around on tall buildings, you know?
Oh, because it was airy.
Nobody
up there.
Could smell.
Yeah, that's all right. Enough of that. So, just show us your
age. Okay, I would have said deodorant, but first he had to shave, so I said razor.
A razor?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a hairy ape?
No. Yep, the hairy ape. Richard?
Yeah, it was actually a great commercial in which he ate Yul Gibbons.
No.
It was for a health food.
You're going to endorse a health food. Okay.
Run.
Now, Fannie.
Faye Ray doll.
Yeah.
Faye Ray
doll. You know, people make fun of Brett, but she really had a wonderful college. She was the first girl to go to college on a football scholarship. I'm proud of it. I said building. Endorsing buildings.
A building.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So, Rosalind, you didn't score there. Darcy, you've got your tie-breaking question yet to go. But before anything happens, we've got to have it going. All right. We're in the middle of a tiebreaker. Rosalind Hills didn't do too well with her half of the tiebreaker. Now let's see how Darcy Bell does with hers. You need one match to win another game. Here we go.
Oh, boy.
Vito said to Dumb Donald.
Who?
Vito. He's talking to Dumb Donald.
What did he say?
Who are these people?
Well, I can see you're a novice when it comes to stick-ups. You're supposed to put a lady's stocking over your face, not a lady's blank.
Oh. Now, you have to do a different reading.
Yes, I do, because it all hit me as I'm as surprised as you are. Vito said to Dumb Donald, boy, I can see you're a novice when it comes to stick-ups. You're supposed to put a lady's stocking over your face, not a lady's blank.
Oh, now.
Now you got it, right? You're the best.
Thank you.
You got the idea?
Yeah, yeah.
You finished?
No.
Have you thought
of
something?
Can you see? It's nothing.
Oh, I didn't say that.
Oh. Gee, I can't say
there.
Anything.
Now,
chilly.
Brett is ready. Are you chilly? I'm glad to hear that.
I'm doctor's grumpy.
Okay. Sneezy.
Dopey.
And I'm ready.
Are you ready? Hallelujah. Charles is ready. Leave him alone.
Put it in there.
Okay. The operator is ready. And here
I didn't pick on him. I was just trying to help.
Vito said to Dumb Donald, boy, I can see you're a novice when it comes to stick-ups. You're supposed to put a lady's stocking over your face, not a lady's blank. I can't hear you.
Bra?
Okay,
okay. She's so hesitant.
This way?
No, it's this
sure.
way.
Well, this way. Oh, I see.
Sort of like blindness.
Not like earmuffs, huh? What do you say?
No, it's sort of like Halloween mask.
Yeah.
I said whole pantyhose.
Pantyhose all together. The whole thing. Okay. Brett? Bra's her answer. What do you say?
Oh, I don't know. I say I'm exhausted.
You are?
I say girdle.
Girdle.
Girdle?
Okay.
Girdle. You know, that thing you wear on a
a living girdle.
That's right, Charles.
I'm afraid Darcy's right. It was a two-faced mugger.
Oh, wings to me. Rosalind, it was a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you backstage together with our thanks for being on Match Game 74. Goodbye, Rosalind.
Bye-bye.
Now, Darcy, this is your third game. You know how this goes. Here comes the big super match go where you can win over $5,000. Shall we start?
Yes.
All right, we pulled a recent studio audience. And we got their best response to this. Beat the blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Second most frequently given response is $250, and the third is $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Richard.
Beat the clock.
Beat the clock is one.
Fannie. Beat the band.
Beat the band. Oh. Okay, there are two for you.
Charles,
have you got one?
Beat the drum.
Beat the drum.
Oh.
So you have beat the drum, beat the clock, and beat the band. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Beat the clock.
You want to say beat the clock. All right. That's the one Richard gave you. That's the one you're looking for. May we see the $100 response? Beat the Band is the one. Who gave you that? Fannie gave you that. Okay. We're looking for Beat the Clock. Here is the $250 response. Beat the Traffic.
God. Uh-oh.
That was a last... great show.
Yeah, great show. I remember it. Here's the last chance for Beat the Clock, the $500 response.
Woo!
Beat
Yay!
The Clock. Congratulations. Woo! You now have $6,800.
Wow.
And you're going to have a go at the big money when we get together again, but right now we've got this for you. Here it is.
Woo!
Gee, it just seems like we started the show 2 minutes ago. All over already, right?
So fast.
Right. Well, we got to hold it till next time. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.
For Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.